Welcome to the pre-work module for your upcoming secondary content area reading school level team training. Thank you for taking the next 10 minutes or so to review some information that will help to set the stage for moving forward on our training day. I'm John Vail, an instructional coach and implementation specialist for the MTSS Technical Assistance Center, who, along with the help of Nicole Coleman, put together this informational set. The purpose of this module is pretty straightforward. It's to get your minds ready for the team training day ahead. So let's get started. Over the next set of slides, I'd like to provide a context for why secondary content area reading is a critical topic worthy of your attention, even in the face of the incredible time demands you have placed upon you right now. As researchers Kane and Oakhill suggest, learning to read is not easy for some students, and learning to comprehend more complex text is challenging for most. Unfortunately, this challenge has not been met for a number of our students as they move through their secondary education. As indicated by this data, this can have lasting detrimental effects. Author and literacy expert Dr. Louisa Moats penned an article entitled "Teaching Reading is Rocket Science." Students who are significantly behind in their reading skills at the secondary level will need intensive, intentional, and extended intervention. As you establish the upper tiers of your MTSS framework, you will be addressing this need. For today, however, our focus is on universal Tier 1 instruction. And the good news, all students can benefit from specific skills and strategies taught explicitly in their content area courses. So let's start with some basics. As mentioned, becoming a proficient reader is not simple. And yet, we place a slide in front of you called The Simple View of Reading. Again, to quote Kane and Oakhill, the point of the simple view of reading is that variation in reading ability can be captured simply in only two components, word reading or decoding, and language comprehension. This well-validated model clearly indicates that if a student is deficient in either of these components, their comprehension is substantially hindered, regardless of the strength of the stronger component. Having worked with a number of struggling readers at the secondary level, I have found that it is highly unlikely that a student would exhibit skill levels that were completely developed, a one, or on the flip side, totally non-existent, a zero. More likely scenarios are the ones suggested on this slide. A student who is an English language learner might have fairly decent decoding skills, but have some confusion of sounds and spelling patterns that conflict with their native language. So let's give this student a 0.7 for word recognition. The same student, however, may struggle with names of some things or with the recognition of idioms, slang, and other jargon. Let's give them 50% for this aspect. The product representing their reading comprehension is 0.35, or about one third that of a highly proficient reader. Another common scenario is that of a student identified as dyslexic, whose listening comprehension can often be very strong, let's say 0.9, but still confuse short and long vowel sounds and have no strategy for deciphering multisyllabic words. Let's give this person a 0.5 for word recognition. Their reading comprehension product is 0.45. Unfortunately, these students often think they are dumb because they cannot read. Finally, think of the student who came from impoverished settings, moved schools frequently, had bigger life issues than schooling, and developed neither their word recognition skills nor their vocabulary and background knowledge in academic subjects. Look at that product. Might reading tasks result in some behavioral backlash? The takeaway is that both elements are critical, and deficits in one have substantial impact on a person's ability to comprehend written text. Suffice it to say, you will continue to have students with gaps in their needed skill sets. The power of the simple view of reading comes in its practical application to the classroom, in ensuring that instruction from preschool through high school appropriately balances instruction in language comprehension and word recognition. Please note two things. First, reading instruction does not end in elementary school, especially as it pertains to advanced decoding and fluency. Strategy instruction is especially important in middle and high school for comprehending more complex language found in core subjects. Second, although not shown above, is the fact that not all students have mastered the word recognition skills when they were intended. As a matter of fact, we have evidence that quite a few students continue to find basic word recognition skills difficult. As we talk about solutions in SCAR, or secondary content area reading, you will notice that most of our efforts will be centered on informational text. Although some content area strategies can be adapted for narrative genres, our main focus is on the application of strategies to informational text. One reason for this is the increasing importance and frequency of informational text in a secondary student's education, encompassing 70% of what they are required to read by 12th grade. Another reason for this focus is that because of the narrative emphasis in elementary grades, along with the story base of most outside of school entertainment, narrative has gotten lots of practice. Informational text, on the other hand, not so much. Text structures, vocabulary, density of content, and purpose for reading are all different for informational text. Additional teaching in all content areas is really needed. This chart depicts text complexity ranges for various grade levels. Notice that the Lexile range, which is one measure of complexity, specified by the Common Core as needed in high school, is roughly between 1,000 and 1,400. Now compare those expectations with the reality of the text complexity students actually experience in high school. They're at the bottom, rounding out around 1,100. Remember, the recommended upper Lexile of the range on the previous slide was nearly 1,400. Now look at the identified complexity bands, with average levels for military being just under 1,200, for the workplace at 1,250, community college 1,300, and a four-year university 1,400. This would suggest we have a preparation problem. To improve reading comprehension, students need instruction and significant practice with increasingly complex text. An observational study spanning an entire academic year by Elizabeth Swanson and her team at University of Texas's Meadows Center for Preventing Educational Risk would suggest they are not shown on the slide, but also assessed in this study was the prevalence and quality of reading strategy instruction. Their findings, not much and not good. By everyone's admission, there are significant barriers to doing this well at the secondary level, but we are not without guidance. Much of the original work of our four-year model demonstration grant was guided by the findings of the Institute of Educational Sciences and published in a practice guide in 2008. The IES looked at the veracity of the research evidence supporting various attempts to improve adolescent reading. The terms strong and moderate refer to the levels and quality of evidence supporting a given practice. Research since that report has essentially supported the recommendations, but also has pointed out the difficulty in moving the dial. This is likely due to the severity and duration of reading issues that have been in play for secondary students and the actual educational structures that exist at the secondary level. The good news is that we have seen firsthand the impact of changing non-reading secondary students into readers. So, as you mentally prepare for our time together, we ask that you reflect on the questions posed on this slide. What is the level of reading proficiency in your school? And on what are you basing this? How much informational text are students reading across content areas? How are students intentionally being engaged and supported in reading increasingly complex text? And finally, what access exists to informational texts in the form of textbooks, ebooks, and articles? Please jot down your thoughts and be prepared to share and discuss at our team training. Thank you so much for your time.